What's happening, guys? Keith here with your October 10th edition of the Impact Report. So we are just four short days away from Bound for Glory, and as usual, there are rumors surrounding the show, one being the return of Juventud Guerrera. So Juvi took to Twitter a couple days ago and said, "This Sunday at Impact Wrestling's Bound for Glory, I'm ready. Let's keep it juicy, ready to set the juice loose." So that is not a name I was expecting to hear, but I guess we will find out on Sunday. So recently, Ed Nordholm was on the Sitting Ringside with David Penzer. This was a good listen. It was about a half hour long. Pretty informative. I'm going to give you guys some highlights. These came courtesy of user Marky Mark on the Freakin' Awesome Network message board. Ed talks about 2017 being a really rough year for them. He said, on Anthem's part as well, but 2018 has been a steady, calm year, and we're slowly moving towards that light at the end of the tunnel. He says when he first came in, he admits they were probably naive in terms of aspects of the wrestling business, says they have produced content before, but not like this. There was a point in 2017 around Bound for Glory when they were thinking of calling it quits. They are, however, very excited on how 2018 has gone for Impact. Don and Scott have not swayed or budged from the business plan they set out around Christmas time of last year. They are very strict on it. Ed talks about how great having Don and Scott have been, and he gives us some information on their roles. He says Scott understands the production, is prepared to work real hard to do it, and understands the grind. He's been great at explaining to guys now it pretty much is a new company with a different collaborative environment. Don is pretty much in charge of creative. He always makes angles and storylines and characters from a business point of view. He does take fans' opinions on board, but ultimately has a very firm belief on how a show should be presented and what will work and what may not. Ed talks about the dropping of the contract and IP exclusivity. He says that he was so confused as to why they went under different names or gimmicks from other promotions. Then wrestlers explain why, and then he removed it. He says he has no say on creative. Penzer had asked if he, like the former owners, planned to make himself a character on TV. Ed says, "I wouldn't put anybody through that unfortunate task of watching me on TV or in general." Ed says Impact has seen a massive growth on the digital side, says TV is not going away by any means, but they are looking to do more on the digital side. Ed says the WWE meeting was about content and ways for them to access our library for the WWE network and keeping regular dialogue and tabs on the business. I'm going to go more into this with Scott D'Amore when he had a sit down on at the Wrestling Perspective podcast. Ed was asked about Chris Jericho and the rumors about him coming to Impact Wrestling. Ed says he can't speak on Chris Jericho. His response was, "What do you want me to get shot?" He doesn't think it's on the cards. And Penzer laughs at this point. He thinks Jericho would be a game changer for anybody, Ed that is. And he says the biggest success for him was bringing in Scott and Don. So, like I said before, Scott D'Amore was recently a guest on the Wrestling Perspective podcast, and he spoke about the WWE Impact Wrestling meeting. This is a transcript from ProWrestlingSheet.com. He seemed to talk a little more about it. He said, "Since the beginning of the year, we've done three content deals with WWE. I think that WWE is seeing that this is a different day with Impact Wrestling, and I think maybe, on the most minute of levels, maybe they're seeing it a different day and age in wrestling." Adding, "There was a meeting, we got together, we talked, and it's kind of like, hey, it's kind of nice to be face-to-face and say hello, and just say that it's 2018, it's a whole different world, and there's no reason why people shouldn't communicate." D'Amore went on to state that there was no agenda when it came to the meeting, saying, "It's just how the business is now," which I think is tremendous. Additionally, Scott claims Impact's current relationship with Ring of Honor is also friendly. So that is good to hear. It's just nice to hear both Scott and Ed commenting on the relationship and talking about the meeting openly. So according to the No Holds Bar podcast via Ringside News, Chris Jericho is likely to show up at Bound for Glory and is reportedly negotiating for a additional appearances. Here's the quote. From what I hear, Chris Jericho and Impact Wrestling are in last-minute negotiations to not only appear at Impact Wrestling Bound for Glory, but also to appear going forward for at least two or three shows. That can fall apart. It could not. Remember, Jericho just appeared in Japan. Jericho has that wrestling cruise on October 27th, so he could do something with that Impact Wrestling event and continue on that wrestling cruise. So it will be interesting to see. Obviously, there has been rumors for a while about Chris Jericho possibly debuting in Impact Wrestling. Now, it would make sense for him to debut in Bound for Glory. It is their biggest show of the year. But again, it's something that we are going to have to see. But it is definitely bringing interest to the product. Also, Impact announced that we are so excited to return to Windsor next year for Impact TV tapings on March 22nd and 23rd at St. Clair's College. So that is really great news that they are talking or announcing TV tapings for next year, as we are unsure of where they will be on TV next year. That is all I have for you guys today. I should be back tomorrow, Thursday, with my Impact review. Friday, I'll have my Bound for Glory preview and predictions video. Saturday, I'll hopefully have up another Impact report. Sunday, there will be no content as I will be attending Bound for Glory. And Monday morning, I will have my Bound for Glory review. So until then, thanks for checking out my video. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks, guys. Bye.